KPRC, AM 950. Houston's more stimulating talk radio.
Eaters and beer drinkers out this Saturday afternoon. Michael Garfield, we welcome you back. High Tech Texan Show. Thank you for following me on Twitter at High Tech Texan, HIGHTECHTEXAN. We got 13,000 or so followers. Come on, let's hit 14,000 today. Follow me at High Tech Texan. All the new follows and shout outs, I'll give you some on air love. Phone number here is 713-212-5950. We are coming to you live from the southwest side of town, Riverbend Country Club. It is really getting packed up. You wear a little jacket. You can try a ton of wonderful craft beers at the Riverbend Beer Fest. Gates just open at 12 o'clock. We go to 5 o'clock, two live bands, got some chainsaw ice carvings, wonderful food. You can get tickets here at the door. I'll be off here at 1 o'clock and then hanging out with all you peeps, taking pics and talking beer and technology and showing off some good tech stuff here throughout the afternoon. So we'd love to see you. You know the phone number. You know what's going on here in the city. And you know one of the powers that I have is to be able to talk to the entire city of Houston. And there are lifelong Houstonians. There are people who moved here generations or several years ago. And you know every time you drive around the south side of Houston on the south side of 610 the Loop, you see that beautiful new NRG Stadium where your Texans play. And right next to it, you see a building. You see a building that is just sitting there, kind of quiet, kind of dark, and kind of famous. It was the world's first domed stadium, and it's still there. And people say, for some reason, what's it still doing there? Well, there are people who do have a lot of affiliation, a lot of ties to the world-famous Astrodome, and one of which is a longtime listener and a friend of mine. His name is Matthew Murphy. And Matthew is now an award-winning film director. Later this week, this coming Thursday, there is a public screening, a debut, if you will, I'm going to call it that, of a film documenting the Astrodome. It is a short film. I am going to be emceeing and holding a question and answer panel, not only with Matthew, the director, but also with several key folks involved with what's going on with the Astrodome, including Judge Ed Emmett and a lot of preservationists and historians. And I wanted to bring in Mr. Matthew Murphy for a while. And Matthew, first of all, congratulations. I've known you for a few years for a number of different things. And did you ever know you're going to win an Oscar one day?
Well, I don't know if it's an Oscar yet, but man, we're really close, I guess. But, It's amazing how life can change on you, and you just have to roll with the punches.
What is the name of this film? How did it come about?
So the name of the film is called Last Seat at the Dome, and it really came about with me carrying my video camera to the seat sale that they had last December. And all I was trying to do is really contribute or really catch my emotions while I was picking up the two seats that I purchased that represented the two seats that my grandmother and I sat in my growing up, and how she taught life to me in those two seats through baseball. And once I got there, I realized there were some other people who kind of had the same feelings that I did. And so I interviewed them and ended up becoming a short film. First ever attempt. I've never done one before. And somehow it resonated with enough people in the film festivals to win several awards.
It's a short film, which is my favorite because I have ADHD and it takes a lot for me to sit through anything, but it's about roughly about 15 minutes. And give us the kind of the gist of what this film encompasses. It's obviously a lot of interviews and a lot of memories.
Yeah, so I was wanting to capture the journey of picking up these seats that were so memorable to me. And so I carried three different cameras, a GoPro, a handheld camera, and then also my DSLR camera, just to kind of capture everything. One on me, one, and you know, that's actually kind of the action camera, and then of course the still shots with the big camera. And so I was taking all of that in just getting the whole experience in, and I couldn't leave. I really wanted to stick around and take a look at the Astrodome, because at the time we had no idea what was going to happen to it. And so then I realized other people were doing the same thing. So I started interviewing them, and I got their information and what they were experiencing and how they were feeling, and then collected it all together, added some historical footage to really kind of help explain what they were talking about. And then, like I said, it came into this roughly 15-minute film that all I had was an audience of the three people I interviewed. But once I sent it to them through YouTube, it blew up, and then everybody really started watching it. And it just took off like wildfire, and it's been amazing since.
Matthew Murphy joining me here on the High Tech Texan Show. He is a film director, among many other things. It is this coming Thursday, and we're going to give you the time and place for the screening. But also very important is you put together a panel of people who are the Astrodome preservationists, and also Harris County Judge Ed Emmett, who has a lot to say with what's going on with the dome. Where does, and we know on this last voter, in this last vote, about a year ago or so, the Astrodome to churn it into some sort of a convention center was shot down. Where do we stand right now with the Astrodome, of what's going on with it as of we sit right now?
Well, you know, to be honest with you, the best person to ask that is Judge Emmett, and since he'll actually be at the panel, we can get the exact answer from him on the current status. But what we do know, based on what he said, is he wants to turn the Astrodome into the world's largest indoor public park. And of course, that is perfect, sits perfect with me, especially on a day that I would like to take Sean out to go throw the ball or something, and go into a climate control environment like the Astrodome to throw the ball would be fantastic. He's actually talking in working with the Urban Land Institute now, who is supposed to be able to release a report, a feasibility study, in December that will determine if being able to turn it into an indoor park is feasible. And then, of course, after that, then it will start to determine how the funding is going to come in. But if it's a park, then you can use Park and Recreation's money. And that's something that we, as Harris County taxpayers, already pay for. So it's not something that would burden us anymore by actually turning it into a park.
Judge Ed Emmett will be at this screening and in the Q&A on Thursday, which is open to the public, and I know you need tickets. Tickets are free. We'll tell you how here in about a minute and a half or so. Who else is going to be on this Q&A panel?
So Beth Withauer, who is a part of the National Trust for Historic Preservation, is going to be there. She's going to be talking about the present state of where we are when it comes to the Astrodome. And then David Bush from Preservation Houston is going to talk about the past and the historical significance of the Astrodome, not only to our city, but to the world when it comes to what some of the major technological advances were introduced when the doors opened at Astrodome in 1965. So I have to tell you, Michael, I appreciate you, hosting this event. No better person would be able to be a great host than the High Tech Texan on the most technologically advanced amount of things that happen in our time.
Well, I remember I am exactly the same age as the Astrodome. So if people want to figure that out, they can go back on Wikipedia and look at this thing. And then when it came about, I mean, this was what they call the eighth wonder of the world. And now the question is right now. And listen, I have been on both. I'm going to be fair. Listen, Matthew, you listened to my show for years and years. I'm on both sides of the line. I understand the historical significance of the Astrodome, but I also sometimes do question of what is it still doing there, because there are some other technological opportunities that could be built. So I'm very interested to hear with Judge Emmett and some of these preservationists have to say. Now, going forward, if anybody does want to attend, it is a free event. There are limited seats. Give us the information of when, where, and how to get tickets, Matthew.
Absolutely. So right now we're about 50% capacity, so they're going to go pretty fast. But you can get your free tickets by going to preservethedome.com. And the event is actually on Thursday evening at Ecclesia Houston Community, which is 1100 Elder Street, really, really close to downtown, kind of at the intersection of Houston and Washington. And the event starts at 7. We're going to have a miniature scale of the Astrodome as a repurposed Astrodome that Micah Costa built to start us off, and then we will have the movie followed by the Q&A, and finishing up around 9 p.m. that night. And once again, you can get those free tickets at www.preservethedome.com.
It's preservethedome.com. That is this Thursday, by the way, 7 o'clock to about 9 o'clock. It's about a 15-minute award-winning film. I'm very anxious to see it, that you put it together, Matthew. I'll be on stage afterwards doing a little Q&A with you, the director, but also County Judge Ed Jimin and a few of the other folks. Good stuff. Listen, I wish you the best of luck with it. I'm looking forward to seeing everybody and just kind of hearing a kind of an interesting heated debate of what's happening with that historical site sitting right there on Loop 610 over at Kirby. But listen, buddy, congrats again on success. I will see you Thursday, and a lot of other folks around the city. We're excited to check it out.
Well, thanks again, man, for everything. I'm looking forward to seeing you there, and let's see what we can do about getting some facts out there.
Gotcha. Okay, that's good. That's Matthew Murphy if you need him. Don't go anywhere as we wind up the big show. We just spoke with Matthew Murphy. He is hosting an open film documentary, a very short documentary on the history of the Astrodome this coming Thursday. I will be moderating it along with a Q&A panel consisting of Harris County Judge Ed Emmett, who is a very key player of what happens to the Astrodome. And so every time you talk about the Astrodome, because why is it still standing? Should something be done with it? It's also a heated debate. If you've listened to my show over the years, I've been in Houston about 20 so years or so, and I am all for forward progress. And I, as sentimental as a guy I am, and I really am, I am about, listen, there is paradigm shift and things need to change and go. The Astrodome, in my personal opinion right now, I have a lot of questions of why it's still standing. And I am looking forward to this discussion, this Q&A panel, where now, where I have had the airways for 12 years, and I have continued to question why is the Astrodome still standing, what's going on? I'm going to be able to have a microphone and to ask Judge Ed, Harris County Judge Ed Emmett, and some of these preservations, what is so important? I mean, there's rats running around right now. When you look at this thing, it's just dilapidated, sitting next to the beautiful, sparkling, almost $1 billion, well, whatever it was, $600 million NRG Stadium. Why is it there? I'm going to get answers. I do want to get the full story for a lot of these things. Maybe they do have some sort of a plan. I don't know. Maybe it's going to change the world. I doubt it's going to change the world. But if you know most of my listeners over the years, they know my opinion on the Astrodome. And so they're wondering, well, geez, Michael, I mean, I know what you think of the Astrodome, why you're moderating it. I want to moderate it because I want answers, too. I am very interested to see this film, Matthew Murphy's film. And I know Matthew. He's a wonderful community-oriented dad, a husband, does so much stuff for this community. It's a 15-minute film, but then the people who are so adamant about what we need to do to keep this structure here standing in Houston, I want to find out what's going on. And that's why we want to invite everybody else to come out. The website is preservethedome.com. You do need a ticket to get in this Thursday at 7 o'clock. It's only going to go for about 2 hours, 15-minute film, and then a Q&A. We want to hear from you. And I'll be up there just kind of answering, you know, and asking my own questions to see what's up. But it's this Thursday. It's near downtown. All the information is at preservethedome.com. And I hope to see you there, too. And this is why this public debate, as much as I'm not a debater, I'm very interested in some of the things, because it does have that sports aspect and it's got a very historical aspect, too.
KPRC AM 950, Houston's more stimulating talk radio.